Alright folks, today we're making a stuffed flank steak roast. So stay tuned. It's time to grill. Let's get started with the stuffing. You will need dried mushrooms or mushroom powder. Today we're making our own mushroom powder. This is dried. These are dried mushrooms I got from a colleague at work. We put them in a food processor and you will gain a mushroom powder, which is full of flavor and full of power. You will also need a gin. I'm using a skin gin today. It has a nice flavor of African mint, which is awesome. Now add cream cheese and you will have a nice and tasty, full of flavor stuffing for your flank steak roast. Of course, you can add more ingredients. You could use a barbecue rub or cayenne pepper works great as well. Feel free to add more ingredients to your personal taste. This is an American beef flank steak. Now here comes the hard part. Take a sharp knife and start butterflying your flank steak. It's easy. Be confident and give it a try, because you will gain something really spectacular and special, because a stuffed flank steak roast is really, really cool. I even made a small mistake. You see the hole on the right side. It doesn't matter, because you will roll it and you will have enough meat around the stuffing. I promise. Just make sure to cut it more or less with the same thickness everywhere, so it gives a nice and plain result in the end. Now salt from inside, and then it's time to add the stuffing. You will now realize that the grain from the flank steak goes from left to the right. This makes us to put the stuffing into the center, and then we are rolling it with the grain, so later on you have to cut against the grain. It's pretty strong. The flank steak grains are pretty long, so you have to cut them, otherwise your flank steak will be a little bit chewy. But I hope you get the point and see what I mean. Here is how I do it. Roll it, leave some space without stuffing at the end, and then take some butcher's twine and start tying your flank steak roast up. I improved a little bit my system on how to do this. It looks better now. It's not perfect, but it looks better than the just cutting down 8 smaller pieces and stuff like that. Really, really good. This comes out perfect later on. We have almost all the stuffing inside the flank steak roast, and this is something like a goal. Now salt from outside, and we are grilling this bad boy on indirect heat, the reverse searing method, which means that we have preheated our grill on 80 degrees Celsius, and we're gonna put this on indirect heat on the warming rack and let it sit there until it has an internal temperature of 52 degrees Celsius. After that time, should be around 45 to 50 minutes, take your flank steak and throw it on high direct heat. You can just use your regular burners, but if you have an infrared cooking zone, such as the Max zone, which belongs to my Landmann Triton gas grill, you can just do that. Just make sure not to keep it too long there. It might burn rather quickly. And of course, we have done everything to have the right internal temperature. We don't want to overcook this too. After taking it off, make sure to let it rest on the cutting board for another 8 to 10 minutes. Then the meat might cool down a little bit and you won't have to lose all those juices. I wish you could smell that. It smells awesome. Okay, that's it. Now, resting time, and after that time, we are cut and see how it did. Take a look at the stuffing. How good does that look? I like. Here, just some close-up. Of course, I'm gonna slice this one. And as always, I'm gonna give this a shot right now. Please make sure to hit that like button and leave me a comment if you are into a stuffed flank steak roast. You can also post your favorite ideas of stuffing for your personal flank steak roast. I really enjoy the color is great, the stuffing is great. Yeah, delicious. Please make sure to subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. Make sure to visit my fan pages. I'm on Instagram, on Facebook. You can find me on TikTok. We have a lot more things to come. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'm out. See you.